Hello for Tuesday, June 7th, and we continued lower again. This is the first time on this chart, and this chart goes from the 24th of January, the first time we've had 4 days down in a row. And we also closed below the intraday low in the mid-April low, which is 12,093.89, and we closed at 12,089.96, so we're below that, but we're not below the 61.8% retrace. At 12,056, we came within about 14 points of that. So if we get down that, that's a level to watch. We may bounce to that level. 12,056.60 was that. We should at some point start a bounce back up, and it could last a little while, like over here when we came down originally to this 20-day as the start of our move down. We see we bounced up for 3 whole days before we came down. Then later we came down also to the 50-day, bounced up a couple of days. We've also bounced up 4 days before, so we should expect another bounce up. That may not mean that we're done with the movement down. If we come through this 1256, we could come eventually down to the 200-day and test that as well, 11,766. When we look at the Russell on the weekly chart, you can see we're not quite to this trend line. Now, if we break that, we could have some support at 764 as well. This trend line goes back into over a year from the 342 low, and then we had the touch also last summer, and then we're almost back to that level again. Note that in the past, we at these lows, like we did in 2009 and then in 2010, we had the Williams indicator come underneath the 80. And right now we're just above it at 79. We're 1 point above it. So if that can come down, and of course normally it's not just one little teeny dip, we're going to probably have maybe even see some of this orange color. So we'll be watching this to see how that goes. Meanwhile, in the last dip, what we had is the RSI moved underneath 50 a little bit. Right now it's at 48. At the big low, this was late 2008, we did come RSI under 30. But in the other touches, we just barely touched it there. And of course, at the low during last summer, we came just under 48. So we'll be paying attention to what happens there. As we look at the shorter term chart, the 60-minute chart, basically it just shows that where the breakdown was for the day as we continued lower, closing down 1281. That's $1,281. If you're trading futures, you can always try it out. By the way, there's a link on the homepage for that. It's free of charge. You can try out the platforms, but there's opportunity to be made, and this is the Russell, as we've said many times, it likes technicals. So as it hit this double bottom and broke through it, that was of course an okay trade. Did try and bounce up just a little bit, but then it continued lower on its course. Okay, we have another one. Oh, well, actually, this is an ETF for the Russell 2000, and you can see here as it broke below that little double bottom that was at 80.76 and continued lower. And you can see where its March low is. If you move that 77.41 across, you come in very close to the 77.33, which is the 200-day moving average. So that would be likely that it would come down and test that eventually. Do note that we are now on Williams getting close to 80, about 3 points above it at 77. And we'll look at RSI, which is at 37. It'd be nice if that could get under 30, actually. Once it gets under 30 and then back up, then that gives you some indication that it might be a good time to buy, that it's worked many times in the past. And here you see on the SPX, the weekly, this isn't as long a time frame chart, that you can see we broke underneath the weekly here. So that is, of course, bearish, down 13 points. We do have the 50-week moving average at 1,248, so that is a possibility. We've got a couple other charts at the SPX as well. Here, of course, was our beautiful setup for the long side to go up and test that 1173 high and beyond, but it failed and it came down. And so first off, failed and dropped below this previous a little dip low, so we're just watching that at the moment as it is going lower. And here you see the break below the 1294, which It tried to bounce at that level and then it came back lower. Do note that on the 60 minute we do have now, we're just under on the RSI, under the 30, and of course the Williams is oversold already, so there could be some bounces there. We will show you on the this is 60 minute chart of futures, and this 61.8, that's very blurry here. That's because we have two levels. One level was was projected from the first leg down back over here on the left. It's off the screen. The second level was projected from the bounce when it came down to this low to a 1294 and then bounced back up. Then 100% brought it to here in 161. So this was an overlap. So we looked at this 1286 as well. That would be a possible bounce point. So we thought that might happen. I'm just looking now and seeing where we are. Now at the moment we're still underneath that, and we've got a little green candle on a 60 minute chart. We're just trying to, if we can move above that anyway, that's an important number, the 1288, because actually that's 1286.49, because there's two sets of Fibonacci projections that get to the same point, and so that's why it's hanging around right there at the moment. Okay, I'm trading the SPX, of course, the S&P 500, SDS would be the way to short. It's the alter short, and of course it's had a good ride from $20 up to $21.98. And next up we have gold. Oh, before we get to gold, we'll mention one other one too, and that is that oil, because, you know, you would think that helped the market when oil goes down, but it doesn't, since oil's been tracking with the Dow going up. But just pointing out that we are in this parallel channel, and we come back to the bottom channel line. We could, if we drop right out of it and can hold that 127 projection at 98.18, that could bounce from there. If that fails, the next level would be at the 61% retrace at 96.76. So that is a possibility. While we're looking at those, we'll skip over. No, maybe we won't. We'll see what's up. Okay, the gold. Gold was up a little bit, 480 on the day. We think at some point it's going to test these high, but you'll notice what GDX happened to it, the gold miners themselves. You can see it was holding above the 20-day EMA, but remember the 20-day was underneath the 50-day and underneath the 200. That's not very bullish, but it was starting to turn up. Anyway, this did break down below that. So as a result, the GDX Orenco chart, mechanical trading, also shifted to a sell or a short sell as well, as we had additional bars got added as it got, you know, as it pulled back more so in the day. Insofar as silver goes, we can take a look at the, first off, the, I'm not sure what chart this is, here we are, the 60 minute. See, for a while, after the good move up in the day, it made this double top here, and it couldn't get out of it. But it came down at first, dropped below, down to our 127% projection, and then moved back up. But then it wasn't able to get any higher above that. Let me look and see if we still have, if I can tell you any more than that. We have bounced up now to 36.94, so we have moved back above that. So at the moment, it did hold. It came down to basically fill this gap area here and move back up. But at the same time, our silver Renko chart is still on, I'm waiting for the computer, I'm still on a short sell here. But of course, if silver goes up, this is going to be kind of a whipsaw and move back up as well. So let's get to see what's happened to stocks for the day. We had a couple things that made some money, and some others that we've taken off the list because they moved just too far away. One of them, like GPRO, had some bad news, and that had not triggered it on the upside. We just took it off the list because it would have been a good short too, because they had some news which took it down. But NUVA broke out of this flag, but because of this market, it had pretty good volume too, a little bit above normal, but it just couldn't continue on the upside. But it's positive when you have a down day like this, and this one's just itching to go up. I wish we had a reversal, because this could possibly be a good play. On the short side, we a couple that we added just on the weekend, or DXCM. This ended up with a 3.3% drop. it triggered to 1446 and it came down, and the first area would be down to this 200-day. It almost got to that. And of course, if that's broken, then we'd look to this filling this gap down here at about 1350 areas of possibility also. So links to watch. But anyway, that has triggered. We've had quite a few more shorts to the list as well. And because silver did bounce, so Hecla Mining did not go down. But of course, there's some worries. You can read some news about some additional worries about some miners in, I believe, in Peru and Hecla. I am waiting for the chart. One moment. If it can come to us here, you can see it just was at the edge. It technically triggered for about 13 cents from 1880 to closing at 767, but it is underneath the support line and below that 771 that we mentioned as well. So now let's go to additions to the watch list. We both have both longs and shorts, depending on what is the market situation at the time. So first off, we have BXP. It's a possibility as it comes down. You can see this 102.44 was a recent low. That would trigger. Now you can see we've had 4 days of negative volume, and it does look like it's setting up here to drop even lower, and it did have a good run up. So Fibonacci-wise, we do have a 101.12. That's a 38% retrace, and that's also at the 50-day EMA. But still, I think it's worth shorting a little bit above that, the 102.44. That gives you only 30 cents, so if you want to, you could wait till the 101.12 is breached. If that is, then we're looking at the 50% retrace at 98.88 and the 61 down here at the support area that was before around that 97 dollar area. So you can check this chart, but that we're adding is a possible short. Also on the long side, tried to break out. Look at that volume, about double the normal volume, but about 4 million shares, more than double the normal volume. And, you know, couldn't hold it with the market being the way it is. But this was after, you know, back last, the first part of May, it had gapped down. But it looks like it wants to run higher. So particularly if we get a turnaround back over that 335 to 340 on a big volume, maybe cool will take back off. Another short candidate, CTAS, under the 50-day, which is at 30.99. Just below that, we do have the first Fibonacci, as you can see here. So watch that area. But if these continue, and if we do, even after a bounce, remember, if we continue, it could not be over in a couple days. It could last for a week or a couple weeks. And note that the Williams did drop below its line as well. So anyway, we have another short candidate in CTASDV under $58.74. Now this had a super 4 million share gap up, and this gap does not need to fill at all. But in this market, it closed right at its low, right at this past low or almost. So if this drops below the 58.74, which is only, you know, 18 cents below where the close was, if it drops below there, it could come down to the 56.74, which is the 38% retrace, or the 55.02, which would be the 50% retrace. So anyway, another short candidate. HAR also short. 45.46 would be a trigger, and then the first area would just be the 200-day. It isn't a big drop there, but remember, the markets could reverse in any of these cases. So just like sometimes breakouts don't work on the upside, they come on the downside. Sometimes these get to the trigger, and then they'll reverse up as well. So obviously, just pay attention to that. HNZ's also a short candidate, under $52.62. It's dropped below the 20-day, and quite often if they drop below the 20-day in a weak market, they could come down to the 50-day. And note that also is a 38.2% retrace at 51.70. So yet another short candidate. HRC also, in this case, under 43.86. This also has at 43.22 a 50-day moving average, and below that the Fibonacci levels are shown. Of course, you can go to the watch list page and look at all these charts in full size and play with them the way you want. Now, OCN since this had that good breakout on Friday, we think we'll watch this. If this can pull back to this $12 or 12,010 area and hold that, that might be a good bounce play. So watch that one for a possible pullback and an entry. PLCM, another long candidate over $61.64. Here we go. It's been moving up steadily, so maybe it's getting a little overbought 3 days in a row, fighting the market moving up. It'd be nice if it goes sideways and then can break over that 61.69. And lastly, we have TICC, another short possibility under $9.84. It was down at 9.20 the last time, but this increased volume here, you know, it dropped, did a little kind of a bear flag, it dropped again, so it looks like it may be going lower. So that's what we have for this Tuesday. I hope you have a good day trading. We've got a lot of possibilities here, both longs and shorts, so I think you have good opportunity to make some money. Thanks a lot for watching. We'll send out tweets throughout the day, so please pay attention to those. And we'll be back again tomorrow with some new ideas. So thanks a lot. Bye-bye.